Hey there everyone, Aiden from BNTouch here, and today we're going to be walking through our brand new e-signature tool that's integrated with BNTouch, integrated with your CRM. We're going to go over a few things today. I'll show you how you can use the tool, how you can upload documents, how they're going to look when they're sent to a borrower, how easy it is to do in the first place, and then sort of what the borrower process is once the document has been sent. So sort of we'll go through the loan officer portion of how to create and send the docs from BNTouch. And then we'll even go through the borrower process of what it looks like to them when they're signing a document and sort of how easy it is to keep track of everything at once. All right. So let's go ahead and get right into it. From BNTouch, you're going to find your eSign tool inside of the marketing tab. So we'll go ahead and click on that. All right. And then we have a lot of things activated here, but you'll see eSign there in the More section if you don't see it on your sort of navigation bar right there. So we're going to go ahead and do eSign. Okay, so this is our eSign tool. It's set up at the forefront very similarly to the document library that you'll see here where you can upload docs. So you can upload any sort of form or template or anything you need signed into here, any Word doc or PDF style of form can be easily uploaded into this. So we'll go ahead and upload a form right now. Show you guys how that works. Okay. So we're going to do this example application form right here. This is a PDF. We're going to go ahead and add that into the eSign library here. And this is what the file will be named inside the library. So we'll do this example application form right there. We're going to give this a second to upload. Voila, and there you have it. So you'll see up here at the top left corner, it'll show you what type of document it is, right? You see you have the docx, the Word documents, and then also your PDFs in there as well, okay? There's a few buttons here. You can edit the template, so that's going to allow you to add all the interactive fields you need to make this an interactive, signable contract or document. And then there's a send button, which will send this to your borrowers, and you'll see up here in the top right, there's actually a little trash can button. So if you go ahead and click that, okay, so this won't actually delete it forever. This will just hide it from your list. So if you'll see here, there's a tab for hidden. Okay, all the documents that you've deleted are going to be put into this section. Okay, so they're not gone. If you delete anything by accident, you'll be able to easily return it back to the library, to your list, with this button here, return to list. Okay. Yep, scroll down there. And that'll add it right back on to your templates here. Okay. So next thing I want to show you guys is how easy it is to actually make these documents interactive and signable, right? So we're going to do that from this edit template button. Okay, this will open up the form editor, if you will. And then you'll see there's a few things going on here. So what you'll see here on this left-hand column, these are all the interactive fields that you can add to any of your documents or contracts, forms, whatever. Okay, so we have signature, initial. There's a checkbox in case you want to give some multiple choice answers or, you know, check if apply type answers. There's input fields if you want someone to just type, right? You'll see here there's, you know, any endorsements on your driver's license, give details, right? You can add an input field if they need to give details or answer any questions that are a little more free form. And then here you'll have a date box, which will actually add a little calendar where they can click the day instead of just having to type, you know, 10, 9, 18, okay? Here you'll see you can actually zoom in and out on the doc if you want to sort of pinpoint the exact spot where you want something to be signable. Let's say something small or you need to add a checkbox. You can zoom in to make sure you put the checkbox right exactly where it needs to be. You can edit the name of the document here. We'll add just a 2 there. Okay, you can close, save, and then here on the right column, it'll show all the pages that are within the document that you uploaded. Okay, you can add interactive fields and signature spaces to any page, to all pages if you'd like. So let's go ahead and we'll add a couple. Cool, so let's say we just want to start by adding initial to the top corner. We want them to initial every page to make sure they saw it. So we'll just go quickly. So you're just dragging it right onto the page here. Okay, it'll add an initial field and then you can actually line it up exactly where you like it. So initial, so we can put it here and see if we can drag it again to the corner and making sure the positioning for everything is just how you want it on the document, okay? So here on the last page, you'll see we have the signed and date fields. So we're just going to go ahead and add the signature. Okay, and this little line here is where it's going to line up. So we'll put that just below the text there. And then we're going to add the date box here. So this is going to be the date field. Again, this will give them a little calendar that they can select the exact date from. Now we'll just go ahead and add, let's see, we got another, okay, we got checkboxes here. So for this one, we're going to go ahead and get nice and zoomed in. All right, let's see here. And all we got to do is sort of line that checkbox up there. Boom. Let's add another checkbox. All right, just sort of get that generally over the box there. And then we'll go ahead and zoom back out. Okay. And then finally, we have the input field. All right, these are just going to be the text field where you can sort of add a little more freeform data here. We'll do one there. And then we'll add another one. Let's see here for the initial. And again, if you want to get rid of one of these guys, you just drag it right back out of the box, right back out of the column. Okay. So we'll add the input field here. Boom. And then we'll put another one here for the address. Yeah. Okay, just above the line. Cool. So we've added a bunch of interactive fields here. This document is now ready to be sent to the borrower and to be completed and signed and re-uploaded for everyone to have. We're just going to go ahead and save the template. You'll see there's a message there that pops up. We're going to close this document. Okay. And then we're simply just going to send it. So we click send and we can either, there's two options to sending a, signable document within BNTouch. The first is the manual where you search the name of the borrower partner that you want to send the document to. Okay. So you can see here we searched Aiden. Aiden pops up. We hit send. All right. One search, one button click. You'll see it says sent. And that'll go to the email of Aiden, right? That'll send the document automatically to them. The second option you have is you can actually add these signable documents to a campaign. Okay. So you can have it. So if they switch from, you know, one pipeline to another, or if they hit a certain trigger, it'll automatically send one of these signable documents that you have ready to go, right from the system. So once you set a couple of these up, you can add them into campaigns specifically for, you know, for what you need, and then you can have those automatically send out to your borrowers, without lifting a finger. Okay. You're going to automate this process, automate this document signing process. So we'll just do the manual for now because it's easier to see it all through. So we just sent that email to Aiden. All right, now we're going to go put our borrower hats on, and we'll show you guys how this looks from the borrower standpoint and how simple it is for them to actually sign these documents. Okay? So you'll see here, subject, your electronic signature is required. That's going to be your name here. So these will be branded to you. We're going to go ahead and open that up, display the images. Okay, so we have this nicely designed, it's a really simple little email here. Right? It has the name of the doc that needs to be signed, the due date, right? Please, the list of documents that need to be signed. We have a couple little graphics here, and then it'll end at the bottom with all of your custom branded contact information and your photo, right? So these are going to be, it's going to be a custom branded to you email, just like all your other emails within BNTouch. Okay. Simply all they must do as a borrower to sign this document is click this link here that says e-sign. Okay. This is going to take them to their portal, their shared portal that you have access to see, that they have access to see. They'll be able to, you know, fill out their applications from here, refer friends, see your contact information, right? They'll be able to sign and upload documents that you need. They'll also be able to see property listings, and sort of their loan process to see what stage of the loan process they're in and when they got there, when the estimations are for when they'll be completed, all that kind of good stuff is going to be from their portal that they'll be able to access really easily and do a bunch of cool stuff. All right. So let's get into some signing. So you'll see there's a couple things going on here. There's a back button so you can go back and see all the documents available. Again, they can zoom and unzoom, zoom in, zoom out on this document as well. If again, something's small and they need to move it around, this can be downloaded right here. So you can download this as a PDF, and then it can be printed all right from your portal, okay? And then we're going to go into the settings tab, and you'll be able to change the initial and the signature style that you write in, right? So you'll see you type in the name, you type in the initials, and then you can select different fonts and styles that your signature is going to show up in. You'll see it changes there as we do that. Okay, so a bunch of different handwritten type signatures. Or you can simply draw your signature here. Okay. We're going to keep it nice and simple. We'll have it be these signature fonts. Okay. And once you save that, you'll just be able to click on a signature spot within the document and it'll just automatically add. Watch. So if we hit initial, see, it'll automatically add the initials in that font that we had. Let's see here. We have the address. Big walkway. So then the bar will just go ahead and start filling out this document as you set it up, right? You have another in-text field. How'd you learn of this? Google search. Okay, so we'll just go through. And you'll see here on this right-hand column, it's going to show all the different pages of the document. It'll even show how many pages there are. And it shows how many interactive fields, that's what these orange tabs are on each document. So a bar will know that they filled out all the fields because they'll be able to count. Okay, I filled out four things. There's four different interactive fields on this page. Now I can go to the next page and they can click right there. Okay. You'll see here we got these checkboxes on there. We're going to initial there. We'll move on to the next page. Initial. Move on to the next page. Initial. So just initialing that we've seen all these pages. Initial. And then finally we'll come down here to our signature. And then you'll see here there's also the date field. So we can select any date we want from the calendar. You can see we can change through the months. All right, October 15th. Then we can also see, you can just sort of type in there, October 15th, 2018. Cool. So that's pretty easy to do. And then when that's done, when you filled out all the fields, you'll see down here at the bottom, there's this little sign document button. Your borrower will just click that. It'll take a second. It's now going to process this document into a PDF. It has all these signature fields filled out, and you'll see right down there at the bottom left, it's just auto-downloaded. So now your borrower has this signed PDF version of the document that they can access really easily, right? You'll see right there, example application form 2, and then we sort of have a summary receipt that is sort of their confirmation that filled the doc on this time. I'll open up both of these real quick so you guys can take a look. Cool. So here we have this, the filled out document. Let's go ahead and we'll just scroll to the bottom. Let's see, there we have the signature there, the date, and then all the other fields that we put in will be there as well. Again, you'll see it looks a little bit nicer on the PDF version than it does within the portal. The technology we have, it actually gauges the fields, make sure everything is the right size as it PDFs the document. So don't worry if it doesn't look perfect, within the portal. It'll sort of autocorrect itself to fit and be all the right sizes once the document's PDF'd. You're welcome to test these yourself before you send them to a borrower to make sure everything looks okay. You can just send it to your own email. So that's easy to do. Okay, so they'll automatically be able to download that. And then when we go back here into the portal, okay, you'll be able to see right here the example application form 2. This is the one we just filled out. You'll see when it was requested, when it was signed. Each one gets its own IP, sort of a unique signature, and then everyone will be able to download the document again. If anyone loses it, you'll be able to come into the borrower portal and grab it. They'll be able to come in as well, and they'll also, the borrower will be able to see any documents that still need to be signed in here as well, along with any other documents that they've stored or shared or uploaded. Again, they can upload documents right from here. So they can upload a document to you, you can make it signable, send it back to them, and then they can re-upload it back into here. Okay, lots of cool stuff you can do. And again, it's all going to be with your branding and contact information attached. Okay, and the last thing I just want to show you guys is once a document is signed, the system will actually automatically send an email to every person involved in this loan, notifying them that the document was signed. Right. So this will be, again, from the borrower standpoint, but you'll see they'll get a confirmation here. You've signed the document. You'll get a confirmation saying something similar here as well. Okay. And then they'll be able to go into the loan portal from here to sign any other documents they have or do whatever else they need to do. So that is our new eSign tool. That's everything on your end, from uploading the doc to adding interactive fields to sending it to borrowers manually or automatically through campaigns. And then it's also everything from the borrower standpoint on how they can easily sign docs, upload them to their shared portal and keep track of everything, as well as download PDF versions. All right, that is our new eSign tool. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Have a great rest of your day, and remember to be in touch.